In this next section, we will review additional aspects of mechanical ventilation beyond the actual settings. These include communication with the nurse and respiratory therapist, additional orders, and your daily assessment of the ventilated patient. It's obviously important to talk with your nurse about all aspects of your patient's care, but this is certainly true regarding managing the patient on the ventilator. Virtually all patients will require some level of sedation and/or pain control. There are no specific guidelines as to whether one should use a benzodiazepine or other forms of sedation, and there are no specific guidelines as to whether one should use intermittent boluses or continuous infusions. One commonly used regimen is to utilize Versed as a continuous infusion, starting at 1 milligram per hour and titrating to a sedation score of 0. Recognizing that there is no actual maximum dose of Versed, it can always be increased if the patient is still agitated and not hypotensive. In addition to controlling anxiety and sedating the patient, one must assess the patient for the possibility of pain. And frequently, a continuous infusion of fentanyl will be used, starting at 1 microgram per kilogram per hour, titrated to the relief of pain. Alternatively, some physicians will utilize intermittent injections of either fentanyl or morphine. It's important to order a chest x-ray after the patient has been intubated for a number of reasons, including identifying why the patient required ventilation, as well as to assess for proper ET tube positioning and to look for complications of mechanical ventilation. In general, a chest x-ray should be ordered immediately upon intubation and daily until the patient is extubated. You should discuss with the nurse whether or not restraints are indicated. Patients who are intubated will not be eating and hence will require some form of nutritional support, often through placement of a DABOF and consulting clinical nutrition for recommendations regarding specific tube feeding recommendations. Any oral meds will need to be changed to either suspension or IV forms. It's appropriate to write a general order to the respiratory therapist to titrate FiO2 to a saturation of 92% or higher. In general, at least one ABG is obtained once the patient is stabilized on the ventilator to assure adequate acid-base balance, and frequently an ABG will be obtained on a daily basis and always at times of change in patient condition. Most commonly, metered-dose inhaler delivery of bronchodilators are recommended, and it's very important to notify the family that their loved one has now been placed on the ventilator. In terms of a daily assessment of patients on the ventilator, I think it is important in the ICU to present data in a systematic fashion. I would recommend stating that since yesterday, these events happened, overnight, these events occurred, and presently, the patient is meaning their vital signs, their examination, and any symptoms that they are experiencing at the time. Regarding the ventilator, I would recommend stating that the patient is on a given mode, rate, and volume, followed by FiO2 and PEEP. Mode, rate, and volume all deal with how a volume of gas is delivered to the patient, affecting CO2 and acid base, whereas FiO2 and PEEP primarily affect how the patient is being oxygenated. On these present settings, the patient's actual rate is, their measured peak and plateau pressures are, leading to a calculated airways resistance and compliance of. We will go through these mechanics momentarily. If the patient has an ABG, the data should be presented with acid base first, i.e. pH and pCO2, followed by oxygenation parameters of PO2 and O2 sat.